switch it up like bam.
Oh, he's hit this one, Miles. Great shot. Oh, it's a biggie.
Hello and welcome to the Stump Mike, the one source for all the chatter on 22 yards and beyond. We are now talking about the pretenders of the IPL 2019. These four teams finished in the bottom half of the league last time around. Let us have a look at each of them and see is baar kuch chance banta hai ki nahi banta unka. So the first team that we're going to start off with is the joint highest number of championship winner team. They are the Bollywood team of the IPL, led by their talismanic captain Rohit Sharma. We're talking about the Mumbai Indians, of course. So Mumbai Indians flattered to deceive last time around, and इस बार सबसे important चीज देखने वाली तो ये होगी कि बाकी teams की तरह उनको 14 match मिलते हैं qualify करने के लिए. या एज यूजुअल वो पहले 5 मैच राइट ऑफ करते हैं और बाकी मैचेस में फिर क्वालिफाई करने का ट्राई करते हैं. दे हैव मेड अ कपल ऑफ रीइन्फोर्समेंट टू देयर स्क्वाड.
आई थिंक द बिगेस्ट न्यू थिंग और द बिगेस्ट एडिशन टू द स्क्वाड ऑब्वियसली इज युवराज सिंह. हैज एट द लास्ट मोमेंट दे बॉट हिम एंड ही इज नाउ गोइंग टू प्ले इन द मिडिल ऑर्डर. एंड द थिंग इज दैट दे आर नाउ इवन कमिंग आउट एंड सेइंग दैट दे आर गोइंग टू रिलाई ऑन हिम, सो ही इज गोइंग टू गेट अ लॉट ऑफ गेम्स. Because Rohit has made it pretty clear that with Yuvraj in the middle order, now I can go and bat at the top. So that much has become clear. They've got Quinton de Kock, who is again a very, very good addition to any lineup. He's a batsman who's shown his quality in international cricket. He's shown it in IPL as well, in glimpses.
Lasith Malika was the coach, Mumbai's bowling coach last year. But this year, he's back as a player. So Mumbai has always had this फैमिली वाली फीलिंग सबके साथ, इसलिए उन्होंने हरभजन को 10 साल खींचा, इसलिए
पोलार्ड इज स्टिल देयर. यस,
पोलार्ड वो तक खींच रहे हैं. सो मलिंगा दे कुड नॉट जस्ट कुड नॉट सी एनीबॉडी एल्स गेट होल्ड ऑफ माइकल, सो इट्स सो दे ब्रॉट हिम बैक एज अ बोलर दिस टाइम. यूवी का सीजन काफी अप एंड डाउन रहा है लास्ट 2-3 सीजन से. डोमेस्टिक सीजन में भी कुछ बहुत ज्यादा मचाया नहीं है उसने, बट युवराज सिंह बीइंग युवराज सिंह, देयर इज ऑलवेज दैट ग्रेविटास अटैच्ड विद हिज नेम, देयर इज ऑलवेज दैट एक्सपेक्टेशंस फ्रॉम हिम. सो यू सी हिम प्लेइंग ऑल द मैचेस इन द मिडिल ऑर्डर फॉर मुंबई, या फिर वो स्टैंड बैक ऑप्शन रहेगा कुछ?
एक ऐसा फेज है उसके करियर में वेयर आई डोंट थिंक देयर इज एनी प्रेशर ऑन हिम नाउ. अब तक ऐसा था कि can Yuvraj have a good IPL and come back into the Indian team? Can he come back into the Indian team? I think that is now pretty much gone. I don't see him. Or I think even in his head, I don't think he is going to think I am going to play fir se shayad India ke liye khel paun. I think the pressure is off. It is maybe the last couple of seasons for him. So it is a very good chance for him to go back on a high and show us that Yuvraj Singh of old.
So Jyoti, do teen jo mujhe इनके स्पॉट में इस बार चेंजेस लग रहे हैं सामने सामने. सो बिकॉज दे हैव डे कॉक एंड बिकॉज रोहित हैज सेड ही विल ओपन, पिछले सीजन के दोनों ओपनर्स आर डिसलॉज डिस्प्लेस्ड. एविन लुईस एंड सूर्या कुमार यादव वर द टू ओपनर्स फॉर देम द एंटायर सीजन लास्ट टाइम राउंड. सूर्या कुमार यादव वॉज अ फिनोमिनल सक्सेस, ही वॉज द सक्सेस स्टोरी ऑफ देयर टीम लास्ट ईयर. और उसके लिए उसको अकोमोडेट करने के लिए नंबर 3 पे ही खिलाएंगे वो, सिस्टम मुझे लगता है. 4 पे यूवी आता है, तो ईशान किशन जिसके ऊपर उन्होंने काफी ज्यादा बैंक किया था लास्ट टाइम अराउंड, उसकी जगह शायद नहीं बनती है बिकॉज यू ऑलरेडी हैव डी कॉक एज योर कीपर.
इट एज यू सेड इट लीव्स रूम फॉर या सूर्य कुमार यादव या फिर ईशान किशन एट दैट नंबर 3 स्लॉट, अज्यूमिंग दैट युवराज पांड्या ब्रदर्स एंड पोलार्ड विल बी द 4-5-6-7 एंड देन द बॉलर्स प्लेइंग 11.
पोलार्ड तेरे को लगता है पूरा फिट रहे, मतलब ही विल फाइंड अ प्लेस कंसिस्टेंटली? लास्ट ईयर ही ग्रॉसली अंडर परफॉर्म्ड.
Well, I think Pollard pehle was in the team as an all-round option as well. Now, I think his bowling has become very limited. I think he is more of an inspirational figure in the dressing room. He's been there for a long time. He kind of brings everybody together. He has that Mumbai spirit. Pollard does not contribute a lot to the team balance at this point because they have Hardik and Krunal. So, if you have 4 bowlers plus Hardik plus Krunal, you can probably go in with a specialist batsman like an Ishan Kishan or somebody in place of Pollard.
But then, Siddhesh Lad, why not?
Or a Siddhesh Lad, yes. But then, that somebody has to have the ability to come in at 5 or 6 and taunt the ball from the beginning. They have
Again,
Ben Cutting.
Siddhesh Lad has. बॉलिंग अटैक लुक्स मोर और लेस सॉर्टेड, मतलब बुमराह हो गया, मारकंडे हो गया, तुम्हारा मलिंगा हो गया, प्लस तुम्हारा एडम बिल और मिक्लेनिगन, ईदर ऑफ द टू. सो बॉलिंग इज प्रिटी मच टेकन केयर ऑफ गिवन मारकंडे कैन डू एज वेल एज ही डिड लास्ट टाइम. सो इन द एंटायर स्क्वाड हु डू यू थिंक विल बी द वन मोस्ट इन्फ्लुएंशियल प्लेयर फॉर मुंबई?
आई थिंक every time the problem with Mumbai has been that they've been slow starters, but I think if they can get the start right, and by start I mean the start of the tournament and also the start of their innings, because every time we've seen that Mumbai is always the team jiske maximum opening combinations try karte hain wo log, and it doesn't work because Rohit always wants to come in at 3 and 4 to control the game. Now that he said he's going to open, and I think Rohit anyway in a team where you have Rohit, he becomes the MVP, because the if he gets going in 3 or 4 matches, he wins you those games. And then
I would feel Bumrah is also a vital cog in the wheel. मतलब Bumrah, हम लोग बात करते हैं Mumbai Indians के MVP की. Bumrah शायद world cricket में सबसे बड़ा MVP है इस time पे. So Bumrah would be the one key player for me. So top four.
I'm just hoping Bumrah does not have to overstretch himself. I'm just hoping Bumrah
World Cup के लिए fit रहे.
हाँ, I think इसीलिए उनका start important है. अगर वो start अच्छे से करते हैं, वो पहले ही 7-8 match में अच्छा खेल लेते हैं, so they have an opportunity to rest Bumrah down the line. It works for us if Rohit is the MVP and Bumrah can take a slight backseat and be ready for the World Cup.
Top four.
Like, I mean, with Mumbai, you can never say no. You have to keep them in contention, especially because they have guys with X factor. They have likes of Bumrah, they have the Pandya brothers, they have Rohit, they have Deacock. So it is too good a squad. So
just like Lord Krishna on the chariot, they have a great Sachin Tendulkar sitting in the dugout. So his blessings also.
Yes, so obviously when you have God with you, you know, nothing can go wrong. But then yes, I think, and if Yuvraj Singh on top of all this can come up with a few good performances, I don't see how Mumbai do not make the top four. They are a good side.
So moving on to the next squad quickly, this team had polarizing IPL last time around. For the first half of the IPL, they were the team to beat. Something happened to them in the second half of the IPL. They could not get a single victory which could have taken them to the playoffs, and then they ended up finishing 6th in the table last time around. They have the bubbliest cheerleader in the entire competition. We are talking about none other than Kings 11 Punjab. They had a very weird season last year. KL Rahul had a season that he will remember for ages. Chris Gayle started off like a house on fire but trailed off towards the back end of the season. Mayank Agrawal se kafi kuch expected tha given the type of domestic season that he was having, but he did not live up to that potential. Karun Nair 300 mara tha England ke against, kafi zyada hype thi uske around, did not deliver as expected. It was a weird team. On their day, they could blow any team away just on the strength of their opening batsman. But when it mattered, they could not deliver that knockout punch during the later stages. Is baar unhone kafi sare changes kiye hain apne squad mein. Let's have a look at their squad. Mir, Varun Chakravarti kafi expensive kharida unhone. Sam Curran ke upar they bet the house. Prabh Simran Singh kafi expensive gaya, 5 crore ke aaspaas mein gaya almost. Nicholas Curran 4 crore mein gaya hai. So kafi sare changes kiye hain. Sarfaraz Khan liya hai. Moses Henriques लिया है,
मोहम्मद
शमी लिया है, तो अननोन कमोडिटीज भी काफी गैम्बल किए हैं. तो किसी ने वरुण चक्रवर्ती का नाम नहीं सुना था उस टाइम से पहले. प्रभ सिमरन सिंह किसी को पता भी नहीं था कौन है. निकोलस कुरन ने 2-4 मैचेस खेले थे वेस्ट इंडीज के लिए उससे पहले. सो हाउ डू यू सी देयर चांसेस गोइंग इनटू द टूर्नामेंट दिस टाइम?
I think as you said, they are a very very good side. They have a lot of variety, they have a lot of options. Obviously, KL Rahul last time had a brilliant season. We, you know, we all felt this is going to be the start of something special, but he has not been able to kick on from there. Another big change, I think, when you talk about changes, has to be in the coaching as well. Mike Hessen has come on board as a coach, and I have a lot of respect for Mike Hessen as a coach with what he's done with New Zealand. So I think Ashwin plus Hessen is a very good combination tactically, I feel.
Very good think tank.
They have Mohammad Shami, who is probably in the form of his life as a limited overs bowler. So that is again a very good addition. Chris Gayle, who again we keep discounting every year, and he comes back against England and scores runs as if it's nobody's business. So I think they have a lot of good options.
But middle order is weak, yaar. Abhi bhi middle order kafi weak. Top three are taken care of: Rahul, Gayle, and Mayank. One down. Uske baad Karun Nair pe, plus he has blown hot, blown cold during the domestic season this year.
I think उन्होंने मनदीप सिंह को भी लिया है, so Mandeep Singh is also.
But can you really rely on Mandeep Singh to save you through situations? RCB ne bahut invest kiya usko, but hardly 4-5 saalon mein usne 2-3 matches aise hain jo apne dam pe jitaye hain.
True. And I think you also need to think how they are going to, the team combination is going to work out, because if you say that Sam Curran, whom they have spent so much money on, is probably one of the only proper all-rounders that they have in the squad. So if Sam Curran plays, if Chris Gayle plays, Mujib obviously is a certainty. He will have to play one of the overseas quick bowlers, maybe Ty to start with. So then, how does David Miller get into that side? Because Sam Curran has that batting and bowling ability. He does not have very good limited overs record. Even in domestic cricket, he has not been a great 50 over or even a 20 over player.
अरे इंडिया ने इस परफॉर्म कर दिया, सबके एकदम आँखों में तारे रखने लग गए, सबके कान खड़े हो गए, उसको खरीद लिया रैंडम. मेरे को सेंसिबल लाइन नहीं लगता सैम करन. उसका ODI रिकॉर्ड इतना अच्छा नहीं है T20s में. इफ यू हैव टू बी अ जेन्युइन इंपैक्ट ऑलराउंडर, तुम्हारे पास पेस होना चाहिए. वो 75 टू 80 माइल्स पर आवर की पेस है उस बंदे की. बाउंड्री क्लियर करने वाला हिटर नहीं है वो. सो ही इज अ वियर्ड बाय अकॉर्डिंग टू मी.
As I said, they have a lot of variety in their bowling. They have an exclusive top order, but overall how they work, I'm not sure.
Do you see them making the top 4? I frankly don't. मतलब they are too heavily reliant on Rahul and Gayle.
I am not very sure. Again, I mean, in terms of how the other teams are stacked up, probably they are not one of the favorites to go to the top 4. Paper at the start of the tournament, probably
they don't start as the favorites to get in the top 4. Yeah, true. I agree. Moving on quickly to the next team. This is a team we see the squad every year. We get excited about them. At the end of every year, we are left scratching our heads. कैसे नहीं qualify किया top 4 के लिए? टीम कॉम्पिटिशन हमें क्लियरली दिख रहा है कि ये हो सकता है, तो टीम थिंक टैंक को क्यों नहीं दिखता है? दे हैव ऑल द टैलेंट इन द वर्ल्ड, द टू बेस्ट बैट्समैन ऑन द प्लैनेट इन द टीम, गुड बॉलिंग अटैक, गुड इंडियन कोर एज वेल, बट दे समहाउ फेल टू क्लिक. नो प्राइजेस फॉर गेसिंग, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द रॉयल चैलेंजर्स ऑफ बैंगलोर. लेट्स हैव अ लुक. Perennial underachievers of IPL, a galaxy of superstars, but somehow choke at the key moments, somehow don't get the combination right. This year they've gone for the stars again. Shemran Hatmat did what you need to do if you want to have an IPL contract: trash India in a game and you get an IPL contract. That's exactly what he did, and RCB spent wildly on him. Let's have a look at the squad now. The key signing in the squad this summer was Shemran Hatmat for around 4 crores. They spent big on Shivam Dubey as well, who is known in the domestic circuits as a tonker of the ball. Plus, they have a pretty strong core as well, which they have retained. Mihir, who amongst these new signees do you see creating the maximum impact this season?
I think from the limited evidence that we have, I think both of those guys you mentioned, Shemran Hatmat and Shivam Dubey, both have the potential to be superstars in the league. Shemran Hatmat has played more than a couple of good innings against India in other places as well. Even in Test cricket, he's shown glimpses of his potential against England. So he's somebody who's fearless. He has that Caribbean swag. And yeah. Shivam Dubey again is somebody who is a more than a decent all-rounder. He is somebody, is that rare commodity who is a seam-up pace, medium-pace bowler who can bat in the lower order and he can start. We know those 5-6s. We know that 5-6 story one day before the auction. So I think those two guys can, because we know that they have Corey De Villiers, they are going to come good. De Villiers has probably been in the form of his life after retirement. He's gone to each and every league
and he's trashed that league's on fire, absolutely on fire.
He's trashed people for fun. He's got strike rates of 170, 180 in every tournament that he's played. De Villiers has not won a major championship if you consider international cricket as well. So I think he might have that motivation to come back to the IPL, give something extra. And I think this time they have their bowling attack also. I mean, last time as well, they had a good bowling attack.
We feel this every year that they have their bowling attack sorted finally. They have a good balance, but somehow they've managed to screw it up. इस बार भी हैव स्ट्रांग एंडिंग को उमेश यादव है मोहम्मद सिराज है जो दोनों इंडिया बॉलर्स हैं
नवदीप सैनी दे हैव पुलन केजरोलिया सो आई थिंक एज कोहली आल्सो सेड दे हैव लॉस्ट द बिग मोमेंट्स द प्रॉब्लम विद देम हैज बीन दे हैव लॉस्ट द बिग मोमेंट्स दे हैव नॉट बीन एबल टू विन दोस की बैटल्स विद इन मैचेस वेयर यू नो इट जस्ट डिफाइंस वेदर यू आर गोइंग टू गो ऑन टू विन द चैंपियनशिप और नॉट आई थिंक इफ दे कैन रेक्टिफाई इट दिस टाइम दे हैव गॉट मार्कस स्टोइनिस एज वेल who has been again in good form in the BBL opening the batting. So once he comes back from the Pakistan tour, maybe he is another option. I think again, you know, you have to say that it is a very good squad. You have to say that they have quite a few bases covered. Gary Kirsten is now in their camp as the coach. So hopefully that also calms proceedings a little bit and gives Virat Kohli that extra confidence to go and express himself. So let's see, I'm hopeful this season. I hope that Virat Kohli by the end of the next 3-4 months has two big trophies in his cabinet. So let's see.
So I see them making the top 4 with this squad as I do every damn year. This year as well is no different. Jitna achha squad hai, they should easily make the top 4. Walk in the park hona chahiye unke liye, top 4 tak aana at least.
Walk in the park, toh log apne liye, matlab they make things difficult for themselves. Yeah. But as I said, I have my fingers crossed and I want to see Virat Kohli with two big trophies in the next 3 or 4 months. So let's see.
To round things up, the one team that we haven't talked about so far, they have a varied history in the IPL. So initially, they had such a team that could challenge even international teams and give them a run for their money. The players that they have released from their squad are good enough to win an IPL on their own. Change the core of the side each time, each season. Still, they haven't been able to crack the
thing. It's the name of the side now.
The name of the side is different as well. We're not talking about Delhi Daredevils, we're talking about Delhi Capitals. Let's have a look.
Back foot pe kya baja raha hai? Front foot pe baja.
Ek josh cha jaye, tufaan sa aa jaye, ae munde Delhi ke.
They start shooting themselves in their own foot midway through the tournament. Last year, बहुत fanfare के साथ गौतम गंभीर को वो लोग वापस लेकर आए थे. Had to step aside from the captaincy 6 matches in. They have a fantastic top four. Shreyas Iyer, Prithvi Shaw. Rishabh Pant and Dhawan back. So probably the best top 4 in the entire league. Still they don't go in as favourites. They have a fantastic bowling lineup as well. You can see Khagiso Rabada is there, Trent Bolt is there. And any team boasting of these two bowlers has to start as a favourite in the match. But still, Delhi are not even in the consideration set of anyone who thinks about the top 4 places. Why is that, Mihir? Why is that?
I think it is anti-KKR. They have 25 options and they have a full squad and so much variety that sometimes they don't know what their best 11 is. And by the time they figure it out, it is too late. So it is a mix of things. But I think this year things are again looking up for them. Shikhar Dhawan is back. They've made a very good sign in Colin Ingram as well. How they use him is going to be very, very, very interesting.
They have Akshar Patel back as well.
They have Akshar Patel, they have Chris Morris who is going to be fit, who was at least starts the season fit enough to play the full season. So he's been a tremendous impact player for them in the past as well. As you said, in bowling they have Rabada and Bolt. They have Ishan Sharma back.
Ishan Sharma.
So they have Saurav Ganguly and Ricky Ponting on board. I don't know how that works. But
मैं think tank के लिए सोच रहा था कि अगर दो लोग जो साथ पे नहीं होने चाहिए, Saurav Ganguly and Ricky Ponting, उन लोगों को उन्होंने मेंटर बनाया है.
So one of them wants Pant to be India's number four. One of them wants Pujara to be India's number four. So you know how things are working. But then yes. So as I said, it is the problem with them is the problem of plenty. And it is if they manage the resources well, as you said, the top four could probably on someday be India's top four. If Rohit and Kohli are not playing in a tournament, that is India's top four, more or less.
For me, the keeper is going to be Ishan Sharma by not playing in the 11.
I don't know. I'm not sure how it works. They have Avesh Khan as well as an Indian part. They have to play one of them. So they have Harshil Patel, they have Avesh Khan. When I mentioned earlier, Colin Ingram is a very, very good addition. We need to see how he fits in because we have that Indian top four. So one of them goes, maybe Rishabh Pant goes a player slower, Colin Ingram goes at 3 or 4. But he's a very, very solid addition in the way he's performed in other leagues. And when you have Rabada and Bolt, it is like when you make your World 11s, you know, these are the guys you would pick as your current day bowlers, maybe along with Bumrah. So I don't see how things can go wrong. But you never know with them. You never know with when Ponting and Ganguly come together what can happen.
Yeah, so I frankly want to see Delhi in the top four.
It's been a long time.
The kind of squad that they have, but because they are Delhi, I don't see them in the top four, to be honest. So guys, that wraps up this edition of our video as well. We have covered all the four teams. Now would love to see your thoughts and your feedback in the comment section below. Who do you feel will qualify as a top four this year? I think we have a pretty open IPL this year as well. There are no clear favorites. The teams who finished in the bottom four last time around do have the squad to overcome the teams who finished up in the top four last time around. Follow us on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram as well. Thank you for watching this video. We look forward to seeing you back very soon. That's it for now. Goodbye.